Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for July to September 2020. After a wet start to the year in Southeast Australia, June has been drier than normal. However, with a shift to La Nina watch, July to September may see wetter than average conditions return. But first, let's look at recent conditions. June days were warmer than average over much of the continent. Darwin hit 35 degrees on the 15th of June, its warmest June day on record. Nights were cooler than average in the southeast. June rainfall was below average across much of Western Australia and outback areas, but eastern New South Wales and Queensland experienced closer to average falls. After a dry first half of June, parts of southeast Tasmania received well over a month's worth of rainfall in just 3 days. Soil moisture continues to be drier than usual in the west and central areas, but in the east, good rainfall since the start of the year is reflected in above average soil moisture. This means that water storage levels in the Murray-Darling Basin and in the South Australian Gulf rose by over 3% in the past month. However, elsewhere, storage levels have been steady or reduced slightly after a dry couple of months. So, what will influence our climate in the coming months? Recent cooling in the eastern tropical Indian Ocean, the result of tropical cyclones and southerly winds, has reduced the likelihood of a negative Indian Ocean dipole developing during winter. However, cooling in the tropical Pacific Ocean may indicate the early stages of a La Nina event, which typically favours above average rainfall for large parts of Australia. About half the international models we survey suggest this cooling will continue, with La Nina forming in early spring. As a result, the ENSO outlook dial has now moved to La Nina watch. This means there's around a 50% chance of La Nina forming in 2020. That's about double the normal likelihood. However, recent drier conditions have been due to a positive phase of the southern annular mode, or SAM. The positive SAM is likely to extend into the first half of July. This means that the July rainfall outlook is neutral or drier than average for much of the country. However, after the SAM pattern breaks down, the July to September outlook suggests above average rainfall will return through central regions of Australia, including parts of the northern Murray-Darling Basin. The streamflow outlook for June to August suggests mostly low and near median streamflows are likely at over half of locations. The forecast high flows are mainly expected in the southeast of the country. July to September daytime temperatures are very likely to remain warmer than average overall, despite the chance of more cloud in some areas. So in summary, July to September 2020 is likely to see above average rainfall through central parts of Australia, despite a dry start to July. Warmer than average days, median to high stream flows, but only in Southeast Australia, and the ENSO outlook has moved to La Nina watch. Thanks for joining us. You can find out more about our outlooks on our website. We'll see you next time.